Now I will tell you how to operate the digital IC trainer kit. So this is the digital IC trainer kit available in our lab. So firstly, this is the power button of the digital IC trainer kit. First we have to on the power button. So one indicator, that is red color light, will come. So it indicates that it is in on condition. And the switches given, 12 switches given here, these are the input switches. With the help of this one, we can make a high and low like this. So this is, I will show you, low means 0, high means 1. So the digital understood only the language of 0 and 1. So low is 0, high is 1. It is indicated by the LEDs over here. So each switch has got one LED like this, so that it indicates whether it is high or low. So at the top of this one, so it indicates, these are the 12 indicators are there. They indicates this is the output that we can see. So once it is high, it shows red light. I will show you with the help of the connectors. These are also called as patch cords. Okay, these are the, with the help of the patch cord only we should connect to the circuit. So with the help of the patch cord, I will connect input to the output, so that you can see here the red light indicated that it is high. If I make it low, it will be in off condition. So high and low we can check. So each LED like this, it can be checked. So if it is indicating red over here, it indicates that it is 1. The output is 1. So these are the IC zigs over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zigs are there. So at a time we can insert 5 ICs out of this trainer kit. So each IC zig at the top side, that is the 4, so they have got the capacity to check 16 pin digital ICs. So this is pin number 1, this is 8, this is 9, and this is 16, and this is VCC, that is plus 5 volts, and this is the ground button. So each IC requires compulsory one VCC and ground button, without which the IC cannot operate. And we should not give the VCC and ground to the other pins, otherwise the IC will be burnout. That is the precaution we should take. For correct pin, we should give the VCC and ground, without which we cannot operate the experiments. So these are the 16 pin zigs. So usually what we are using, AND or NOT, XOR gates having only 14 pins. So no problem by issuing these 4 zigs. So at a time 4 ICs can be checked simultaneously. If the IC exceeding 16 pin are there, below one zig has been given, that is one bigger one. So it can check about 40 pin ICs, it can check. So pin number 1 start over here, 20th over here, 21st and 40, up to 40 pins we can see. Again we can see the VCC and ground for this also. So for each IC zig, VCC and ground pin are compulsory, and to operate the IC in a proper manner, we should give to the correct pins VCC and ground.